Today, as modern science seeks to understand the miracle of creation, it sees an infinite universe, cold and dark, inconceivably vast, without beginning, without end.
Majority, 99% of all narratives in the cinema are based upon Christian ethics. Create a situation of unrest or evil and try and find a reconciliation. Whether it's a romance or a thriller, it's the same boring old formulaic perception.
Seres humanos são animais mamíferos, bípedes, que se distinguem dos outros mamíferos como a baleia ou bípedes como a galinha, principalmente por duas características: o teleencéfalo altamente desenvolvido e o polegar opositor.
In the beginning, man's world was his cave. His only concern was for food and companionship. With the sun came the day, bringing warmth and light. With the stars came the night, bringing darkness and fear. Later, when man became a shepherd, he spent more time contemplating the mystery of the stars. Because they moved, he believed them to be living things. Possibly the children of the moon breaking away when the moon grew smaller. Then he noticed the reappearance of star formations he had seen before. Where had they come from, and where were they going?
O teleencéfalo altamente desenvolvido permite aos seres humanos armazenar informações, relacioná-las, processá-las e entendê-las. O polegar opositor permite aos seres humanos o movimento de pinça dos dedos, o que por sua vez permite a manipulação de precisão.
Cinéma, car ce petit objet sublime que c'est un polygraphe de l'hôtel Saint-Régis que j'embrasse contient dans sa petite minime section métallique tout le film et toutes les images hallucinogènes que Dali vient de vous imposer à votre cerveau.
Philosophers gave the world many profound conceptions of Earth and space. Plato said, I have found the Earth to be the perfect shape of a cube, standing in the center of the universe with all other heavenly bodies scattered round and about. Anaxagoras had this to say,
Being in the center of the universe, the Earth is assailed by the rotating ether, which tears away bits of Earth, flinging them outward, setting them afire, creating stars and planets.
Then there was Aristarchus.
Gentlemen, I disagree. The sun is obviously in the center, with the Earth and other planets traveling in circular paths. And thus, the sun is...
Finally, there was Ptolemy.
Learned men of science, I have listened to all your arguments. I now decree that our great Earth stands immovable as the hub of the universe. The supreme center of intelligent thinking.
Oscarshofus. Oscarshofus. Tendrzimachus.
We are at the end of the 19th century, all over the world. I mean, in Europe, in Germany, in England, in France, in America, a lot of people are trying to animate the image, the still photography. Renault, Le Prince, Demeny, Muybridge, Skladanovsky, Marais, and of course, Thomas Edison. In the summer of 1894, Antoine Lumière, the father of Louis and Auguste, goes to Paris and watches, assists to a demonstration of Edison's kinetoscope. He's very impressed. He goes back to Lyon to his two sons and tell them, you can do better, try to get that image out of the box. February 1895, they register the pattern of what they will call the cinematograph, coming from Greek, which means writing the movement. The first film was shot on the 19th of March, because they shoot that film between March 15 and March 20, and all the other days it was raining. The only sunny day is March the 19th. So at 11, between 11 and 3, they shoot the first film. The history of invention stops there. History of filmmaking begins.